Hi everyone. Okay, I said hi everyone and got taken off.
Can you hear me at least?
I don't know if we're now officially live or we're not. Yes, it says we're live, so let's do this. Hello everyone, I'm Anupama Chopra. I'm the editor of Film Companion. Welcome to a very special event with Kareena Kapoor Khan, in which she's going to talk about her new book, Kareena Kapoor Khan's Pregnancy Bible, published by Juggernaut Books. And a big shout out to our hosts for this event, Mom Imperfecto, Gurgaon Moms, Kids Stop Press, Sipping Thoughts, and Baby Chakra. Kareena, it's always so lovely to see you.
I know, amazing. But now too much of the Zoom has happened, I think, in 2 years, right?
Yes, we have to meet. And I want to tell you that when we look at you, Kareena, we see this impossibly glamorous movie star living this sort of impossibly glamorous life. There's the gorgeous husband, gorgeous kids, red carpets, there's the vacations in the Maldives and Stad, and it all just looks amazing. But in this book, and what I love most about this book is that you puncture all of that, all right? You're talking about nausea, you're talking about exhaustion, you're talking about your granny undies, your lowered libido. I mean, it was amazing. There's even a picture of your feet.
Yeah, swollen on the set.
Yes, not very attractive. Tell me, why was this important for you?
Actually, it wasn't so thought of the way, obviously people are assuming, or the way you've asked me. Of course, there's this glamorous life, but a glamorous life, or like going to the Maldives, or like you said, a gorgeous husband, has nothing to do with what I have felt, or a pregnancy that is as normal as the rest of the world. Because A, it's very normal to have children, carry children 9 months in, experience whatever you've asked me. I think it's the most normal thing. The only thing that's not normal about it is a mainstream actor whose glamorous side you just keep hearing about, but you never hear the side that's the most normal. So that is what, for me, is like, I was like, if I have to do this book, it has to have everything about it what I actually feel, and which you asked me, whether it was like, the breastfeeding that we spoke about, the guilt that a mother goes through, the fact that, I didn't feel as beautiful in my second pregnancy. All these things, I think, are the most normal for a normal mother, like in Gurgaon. I mean, I'm sure she feels that, but she would never think, like you said, that, okay, Kareena Kapoor is feeling the same thing. So just to normalize the fact and to let people know that we also are very much normal. It's not just about the sunkissed glow in the Maldives. It's not just about that. I mean, that's just like, I think, 5% of our life, which gets blown up by the media, but this no one really talks about. So, and also, like I said, first time an actress addressing issues of, not feeling herself, or swollen feet, or feeling ugly, or granny undies, or like not getting enough milk. You've never heard a mainstream actor address such topics.
Yeah, absolutely. You also talk about how, because with the second pregnancy, you were older, of course, you were also far more exhausted, and yet you kept going like you did with the first. You're working till the end of it, okay? You talk about a point where you actually passed out at a brand shoot, I think it was.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you still just keep going. I want to understand that, Kareena. What did you do to just will yourself to power through all of this?
Of course, just the idea of the fact that I've always worked all my life from the age of 17. I've not been the kind of girl to be like, okay, this is it now. I've had my, share of success, or I've done this, I've done that, I've made enough money, and now I want to hang up my boots. I've never been that kind of girl. I want to always keep doing something, keep working, looking for more. So even if it was the second pregnancy, which was with Jay, I mean, the whole world was traumatized. We were all in this, you know, suddenly like this, I don't know, back to the future-ish kind of thing. Like everyone was in this Star Trek movie, you know, in COVID. And I just happened to find out that I was pregnant. But I think the idea that, you know, I don't want to stop, I can do it. I can obviously take all safety precautions and still do it. And of course, the support of a loving husband, having that time with him at home, having him encourage me that, you know, it's okay, we can do it. And if you want to, just be safe and do it. Like I shot Lal Singh Chadda when I was 5.5 months pregnant. I actually did a romantic song in the film, carrying my baby with Aamir. So that's gone down in history. So I think that, you know, just the confidence, you know, and people who know me, like I just find that confidence, I just find it in me and say that, you know, just because it's COVID, just because I'm a woman, just because I'm pregnant, these things can't just be, it can't be just because. It has to be that it's okay that I'm doing this. I am pregnant, but I can do it. And I think every woman has that. You just have to kind of, you know, tap into it and find it, you know, that's the whole thing. It's like finding it inside you. And of course, like I said, you know, you have to give credit to surrounding yourself with, you know, positive people or, you know, whether it's family or friends, just interacting with people who kind of support you rather than, you know, give lecture you or tell you that, oh, you know, you should be doing this because you're pregnant and, you know, it's not the right thing or you come across wrong. I don't keep such people around me.
You do well. Now, the book, Kareena, is dedicated to Saif and your two sons. What do you think is key to raising boys who have a respect for women, who understand that women are their equals?
Well, in the case of Tim and Jay, I think the idea is that they see me go to work even now. You know, like when Temur asks me, every time he sees me put on my shoes, he's like, where are you going? And my answer is, I'm going to work. I'm going to shoot, or I'm going to an event, or I'm going for, you know, a meeting. I'm going to work because Amma has to work. So Abba works also, and so does Amma. So I think he's growing up looking at the fact that in this house, it's not just the man who does things. We both do things equally. We're both bringing food to the table. We're both very clear on the fact that we're both working as a couple. We're dependent on each other emotionally and financially we share. And if my boys grow up knowing that their mother, who is a woman, has the capability and demands that kind of respect in her home and gets it, goes out to work, works hard, comes home so that, you know, they can have a good life, I think that's half the battle won, because that's so important for the boys to know that women are a man's equal. A mother is their father's equal. Yes, a mother can be the emotional one and the one who gives all the cuddles and this and that. And we all do that. But I think Temur is also growing up to know that his mother's quite strong and, you know, she has long hours. Like, you know, he saw me working when I was pregnant. I used to go to shoot at 6 in the evening and come back at like 7 in the morning.
Wow.
We did all nights. Like we did like 17, 18 nights in Delhi. So he would be waking up and I would be coming home. And, you know, we would have like breakfast together. And so he's seen his mother do that. So I'm hoping that the fact that he learns to respect and understand that women are men's equal is him looking at me.
Yeah.
I don't want to be that kind of mother to point a finger and say that, you know, okay, this is, you have to respect women or you have to do that. I think it should be there. He should grow up in that atmosphere. He should know that that's just the way, whether it's Karishma working, you know, my mom has always worked. Saifu's mom is working till today. His sisters, she has a daughter. So I think it's your atmosphere, you know.
It's what
rather than, yeah, it's setting an example with the things that you do around them. Rather than, you know, telling them. Because I think that the more you kind of point a finger and say, do this or do that, kids, you know, they just don't. They don't imbibe that. They have to imbibe the atmosphere, you know. So I think that, you know, Saif and me are very cosmopolitan. We are very, like, open in the house. And that's just the way we want both the boys to grow up. Just looking at us and, you know, feeling it and just being there.
You know, Indira Nooyi, the former chairperson of PepsiCo, who's also written a book recently, said very famously, Karina, in a 2014 interview, I think it was, that women can't have it all. Okay, she said that the biological clock and the career clock are in total contradiction of each other. Her exact words in that interview were, "We're screwed." All right. And she said, "My solution is coping mechanisms." Okay, so, and then talked about what, you know, her extended family, her secretaries, the way she kind of managed her life in a very, very demanding job. Do you agree with that, that women can't have it all? And what are some of your coping mechanisms?
I mean, you know, I think, I don't know if women can't have it all, or I think women, you know, can make things happen. I also know that they, of course, they're multitaskers, but also I feel they're very smart and very shrewd compared to men. I think that we just know how to make better choices, better decisions, you know, kind of handle situations, be the calm one, be the anchor actually in most things. I've really seen a woman be not in control of herself. Somehow it's just there, you know, they know how to control, they know how to take charge of the situation. So maybe not having it all, but I think making the best of it all, or making the best of what, you know, situation you are in, what you have, and making things happen for you. Yeah, you have to make things happen. I mean, the idea is that everyone, like Sedna, that when you get married and now you have two children, you know, nothing's going to happen. You're not going to work in movies and things like that. I mean, I'm reading scripts still today, but I'm like, listen, I don't know. I mean, I want to do all four scripts, which I love, but I can't right now because of the children. So I need to take that decision that I just do one, or, you know, basically like one a year or two a year. So that's the kind of decisions that I think we need to do. And maybe that's why I would love to do all four, but I can't. But I'm also not the kind of girl to be like, okay, you know, I regret it, because you can have it, but you have to balance things out, right? You have to know that when your kids are going to need you, when they have, you know, they want you, they have that time. So, yeah, I mean, like, I'm happy making that decision and saying no to some people and then, you know, focusing on that one project that I'm excited to do.
Tell me, after more than 20 years in the business, you've turned producer with Hansal Mehta's film, which is so exciting. Karina, do you think women should have more control on movie sets? Is that why you took this step?
Well, I think that whether you've seen, we have quite a few bright minds out there, from Zoya Akhtar to Ekta Kapoor to Guneet Monga. We have lots of women who are ruling the production, so, you know, kind of forefront, making brilliant films. I think doing that, you know. So, Anushka Sharma, I think that we've all, I think, like I said, every woman has it. Producer, I think that I, you know, it was just something that, because I don't think I had the director gene, but it's a script that I loved. Something that I said, okay, why not? When Ekta offered me that, I said, yeah, I think it would be quite interesting to also now, you know, have a little more control over the scripts and that the films that I can do, you know, after 21 years. I mean, I would love to give my input or just, you know, be a part of the production so that I know that, you know, it's the best and I have something to offer, you know, whether it's my mind. So I would like to, you know, share it. So I think it's only because of that rather than anything else. And also, yeah, I don't think I could ever be a director. I don't have that kind of, you know, I think that level of commitment is very, very different, you know.
So it's interesting. You've actually become a producer before Saif.
Oh, no, Saif produced Love Aajkal and all
right,
that.
That's it. He did that back in the day.
Yeah.